Hi, Mr. Tarrou again. While I get my TI-NSpire out, let me show you one of the really cool features that this calculator has over the TI-83 and TI-84s, besides the fact that the graph is more detailed and I have the X and Y axis labeled, where of course you don't get that on a TI-83 and 84. Well, one of the things I can do with this calculator, though honestly, day-to-day use, I do prefer the use of the 83s and 84s for my statistics class. They're just much quicker to use. I can take one of the points within the scatter plot, which is nice and linear, and that regression line is, you know, following those points very well. I want to talk about the difference between just a regular outlier and an influential point. Neither one are good for regression lines, by the way, because, well, regression lines are not resistant. They use the mean in their calculation. Now, as I move this point around, if you've never used one of these NSpires, you'll see that it is actually moving my regression line as I move the point. It's recalculating that line for the point that I'm moving. And that's a really neat feature. I can see live the slope and the y-intercept change as I move that point up and have it become now a vertical outlier. That vertical line, by the way, is just the y-axis. So now I have a regression line that follows the points well, but of course it's overestimating all those actual y values, so the line is no good. It's being influenced or getting pulled up towards that outlier because the line is not resistant. Now, that's a regular outlier, and the line's no longer any good. It's overestimating consistently all the other 5 points, even though the slope of the line seems to follow the slope of the other 5 points fairly well. That's an outlier. Regression lines are not resistant, and that regression line now is really no longer all that useful. If I move the point over to the left, and you know, I'm still going to have that point pretty far off by itself, but now that point is no longer an outlier because it's following the linear pattern that the other 5 points followed, or excuse me, set up. So that line now, or that point where I've placed it now, is no longer an outlier. And that's good. The line is now a good linear model of those points and would be a good predictor of y values. If, however, I drag that point down and I make it an outlier in the horizontal direction, now you can clearly see that the line is no longer following, it's not even following the same slope as the other 5 points, and it's even more strongly affected by that outlier in the horizontal direction than it was in the vertical direction. So, just to show you the difference, through some active calculator work and display, that there is a difference between just a regular outlier and an influential point. Remember, influential points are outliers in the horizontal direction, and neither one are good, but, and regression line is never resistant. But vertical outliers do not affect the line as strongly as a horizontal outlier, which we call a influential point. So, thank you very much. I hope you have a great day. Good luck with your stats, and I appreciate you watching. Bye.